That's it for me. Have a great rest of the evening with Gary Davis. I'll see you next week. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Nikki Cardwell. The Bank of England says it will not hesitate to raise interest rates to bring inflation under control after the pound slumped to a record low against the dollar. The financial markets have been rattled by the government's plans for big tax cuts to be funded by borrowing. There's been speculation that the bank will act earlier than scheduled to increase the base rate. Some mortgage lenders have temporarily withdrawn deals. Nicola Shutrups is a broker from Southampton. She says those looking for a new mortgage might find themselves worse off than they may have expected.
People don't necessarily equate interest rates to pounds in their pocket. There are around 1.8 million people coming off of fixed rate mortgages in the next 12 months. But what that means in people's pockets is the average mortgage is about just under £240,000. It's going to be adding about £800 a month to your mortgage.
Two teenagers have appeared before magistrates charged with the murder of a 15-year-old boy in West Yorkshire. Carrie McLean died last Wednesday. The boys were remanded into youth custody until Wednesday. Investigators in central Russia say a gunman who killed 17 people in a school, including 11 children, was wearing a neo-Nazi symbol on his T-shirt. Artem Kazantsev, who used to be a pupil at the school, is thought to have killed himself after the shooting. Svetlana Petrenko is a Russian investigator.
The attacker killed himself. It has been established that he was wearing a black T-shirt with Nazi symbols and a balaclava. He had no documents on him.
The French Prime Minister has warned that any new government in Italy must uphold human rights after the country's election made the far-right Brothers of Italy the biggest party. The European Commission says it's hoping for a constructive relationship with the new government, which is expected to be led by Giorgia Meloni. Ileana Lucaselli is a Brothers of Italy MP. She was asked if the party should be described as far-right.
No, it's not. Fratelli d'Italia is not an extreme far-right party. We are center-right and we are conservative. We want to look at the future in a conservative way, but also understanding that we are in 2022. What we have is a new way to look at the right.
A member of the House of Lords has been banned from driving for 6 months, despite claiming that he needs his licence to arrange the King's coronation. The Duke of Norfolk, who was also responsible for organising the Queen's funeral, pleaded guilty to using his mobile phone while behind the wheel in April. Football and England have been denied their first win for nearly 6 months after a dramatic draw with Germany at Wembley. They came from behind to lead 3-2 but conceded an equaliser in the 87th minute. And the weather, breezy throughout the night with more showers in northern and western areas, clear spells everywhere else. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past 10.
Thank you, Nikki. Thank you, Karis. Hello.
Woo, Gary Davis. Woo, Gary Davis. Woo, Gary Davis. I'm your radio.
Davis, Magnificent Seven.
Good evening. So Trevor on his holes for the next couple of weeks, so it's my pleasure to look after you here on the Rhythm Nation all this week, which I'm very excited about because I'm a bit of a soul boy at heart. Got some amazing tunes to play you tonight, kicking off as always with the Magnificent Seven.
The Magnificent Seven on BBC Radio 2.
If you want to get in touch, you can text me 88 to 91, you can WhatsApp me 08000 288 291, or email me gary.davis@bbc.co.uk.